Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Kirby's Epic Yarn. Last time we went through the start of the game, went through two major worlds, and now we're going to go through Treatland. And if I remember correctly, this is actually one of my favourite worlds in the game. It's like, there's a lot of interactivity here, and it's just kind of just fun to play around in these stages. And I mean, just to, I guess, start on this topic, one thing that I guess could be a little bit divisive between players would be that this is a lot more slow-paced than the other Kirby games, which I can understand why, like, some people won't necessarily be a fan of that, but I honestly never really bothered me that much, so personally, I'm totally fine with this more slow pace of this game, and I think it suits it well. Like, if it was, a more fast pace and all that, I don't think it would have really fit the more, child-like, appeal, I guess, because this is a lot more, child-friendly, I guess you could say. It's like, Kirby games are obviously meant for kids, but there are some things that are pretty messed up. Mainly speaking towards, like, final boss materials and material and stuff. I don't remember the final boss being that disturbing in this game, though, and again, it's a lot more chill, and it's a different take. Like, I'm totally fine with that. If it was like a mainstream Kirby game, then it would be a bit different, but hey. And music, I think the music works really well with this game. Like, it's mainly piano focused, and I think that kind of suits the art style very well. And again, it's just very peaceful, not really a stressful game at all. You can just relax easily and get crushed like that. It's always fun. Okay. I need to stop doing that. Alright, this is bad. Alright, there we go. Don't know what I was trying to do there, to be honest. Yeah, most of the time it's just better to turn people into a yarn ball. I can't remember. Well, there are, I guess, like speedrun reasons why you'd want to just shred people up, but I mean, just in case there's like a block to destroy, then you may as well do it half the time. Not seeing a lot of beads here. That should change. That needs to change soon, because this should give us a good amount. All right, no. Yeah. Nod that head. Oh my gosh. Nope. Don't fall. Oh, I see. He needs to just keep still on these things. want to go back. Stuff the... Nope. Why did I do that? Gosh dang it. Okay. You die. Anything? It's just nice, peaceful. Alright. Now that's the only one I really care about getting. If we... I hope it doesn't come down to having to rely on the end goal for the medal, gold medal, but... I mean, we can probably do it. It's not getting like the 5-star reward or whatever isn't the hardest thing in the world, but there's a potential of me just messing it up. But yeah, like that's a tradition with Kirby games though. Like they usually have like a end level mini game or whatever, and I probably say this one's the easiest to get like the perfect on. Okay, I have to go down here first. Yay! Okay, what do we have here? Oh, okay, the train. And that mouse is annoying. Alright, this is, I'm not really a big fan of this one, mainly for the fact that it can be a little bit messy sometimes. And it's like, I don't know, it's just... probably one of my... Honestly, I'd probably say this is my least favorite transformation in the game. And... I mean, it could be worse, but... it's just kind of a mess sometimes. Especially when you're just trying to collect everything. Like, look at this. Like, I'm kind of failed, but... even still. It's like, it moves by itself, and... just trying to... get the train in the right direction is just kind of a hassle. And it does that sometimes. Alright, no, go back. There we go. I just want to get... oh, okay. I want to get up there. No! Okay. Go back here. Alright, that should do it. Alright. Oh, did I miss one? Is that it? Oh, that's just another thing for the train. Doesn't really do anything, gameplay wise. Whoa! Or maybe I have to get all of these to get the last treasure. Yeah, I see. Well, that's another train thing, I think. Alright. Nope! I mean, I can't see any other reason why you'd need these, to be honest. Go back. What the hell happened there? Okay, seriously. Alright. Bless food! Alright. It was just for beads. Seriously? Why do I keep pressing that? Okay, I'm gonna have to play that level again. Alright, whatever. I got a gold. Yeah, I don't know where that treasure would be. I swear I looked everywhere. Maybe it's near the stomping robots. Alright. Yeah, I was getting a little bit worried there because I wasn't finding anything for a while, so just a bunch of beads. I ain't gonna do that yet. Sounds fun though. Alright, I'll be back as soon as I find this thing. Okay, I found it. Alright, cool. I have to finish the level though, right? Or can I keep it? Alright, I have to finish the level. Okay, my bad. Okay. At least I know now, because... Otherwise, I'll just be like, no, you can't keep quit the level, what are you doing? Yeah, either way, though, I'll just see you guys in the second level. Done. Let's go to the mushroom land. Oh, this level is giving me very heavy Yoshi's Woolly World flashbacks. Or flash forwards, I guess, since this game came out way before that game, but either way, kind of has a similar vibe going on. And I need to go back to that game, like, I stopped after, like, World 2, and I just never went back to it. And, I mean, I don't really have a major reason why. Like, there's just a lot of games to play nowadays, especially with me with my massive backlog, and it's just, like, there's just so much to, so much to do nowadays. Like, you have so many shows to watch, so many games to play, so many movies coming out now, and it's like, nowadays every day there's just more and more entertainment to consume, and it's really cool though, because like, it's very, very hard to get bored nowadays because there's so much to do, but it can be a tad overwhelming at times. And speaking of overwhelming, that is one reason why I've taken so long to finish Woolly World is that I know that Yoshi games are known for tons of collectibles and stuff, but after, like, just don't know, a couple levels or so, I kind of get a little bit drained. And this is coming from a guy that loves, like, collectibles in games. Like, there's a reason why Banjo-Tooie is one of my favorite games ever. And I didn't really mind the Sun and Moon medals in Unleashed. But with Woody World, it's like, you have to, like, look, explore every nook and cranny, and there's so much to keep in mind there. There's just something about it, like, it just kind of makes you feel drained after, like, two levels or three or so. And not to say that I'm not enjoying it, like, I really do enjoy Woody World, and it easily rivals this game. I'd probably say this game is easier for me to play through, but in terms of, like, just pure level design and just unique set pieces and whatnot, Woody World definitely shines with that. And why can't I get up there? Come on. I feel like I can do that. Like, I don't see any of... Wait. Oh, there's that. Oh yeah, there's nothing else here, I think. Aside from these guys. So I just need to, like, rev it up. Okay, there we go. I guess I just need to swing a little bit, but it didn't look like I was getting any higher. Oh well. Woo. Yeah, this is definitely giving me the urge to go back to Woody World and actually try and complete it. But yeah, most of the time when I haven't been, like, recording or most of the time when I've been able to, like, pick up something to play, it's usually been Zelda for the past few weeks. And I mean, I don't think you can really blame me, because, like, this is a game that we've been anticipating for a good 4 years, maybe? Like, it got, like, announced that Zelda Wii U was gonna happen, like, 2013, maybe? I think 2014 was when we got an actual trailer for it. Like, the Guardian chasing Link and all that good stuff. And, yeah, it's been a while. So, if you count, like, just Aonuma saying, oh, we're making the game, yeah, it's been like 4 years. Or more like three and a bit years. Like 3.5 maybe, but still, it's been a while. And there's just so much to find in that game. It's insane. Like, I've been, like, every day, like, I find something new, and I don't want to finish the level yet. I'm missing the music. And I'm assuming it's that. Well, it could be down there as well. Alright. Yeah, don't care about you. Yeah. I've been slowly trying to play other games. I did play Crash of the Titans for that live stream this weekend, which, you know how I feel. Yes, you've watched it, you probably know how I feel about the game, but yeah, I'm just kind of glad I have that off my backlog now, because I always plan to stream the Crash Titans games, but again, Zelda and a couple other things, like a job and trying to actually edit things for once. I still don't have the disc or CD. Where is it? Or is it behind this end? No, it's not. Oh, hey. It should be that. I don't know where else it could be. Alright. Oh, come on, what? It is here, right? In this area. Because I don't really know where else it could be. Let's just go in the lower levels. Over here. Yeah, where else could it be? Is there any way to get up there? Okay, it has to be that. Oh, okay. Alright. That was decently hidden. I mean, the more open you make the area, the harder it's gonna be to find what you're looking for. Yeah, I didn't think the end was over there. Alright. Alright, cool. Alright, the more bees we get, the better, because, We need to get as many as we can so we can buy all the stuffs. Because it does count to 100%. Cakes. I kind of like how the edge of the world is like. Filled with that kind of iconic Kirby-looking, like stars with a dark blue, like color to it. It kind of looks like Nightmare. As you remember from Adventure. Don't know if Nightmare is in any other game, is he? Well, I know he's the main villain of the anime. I know that for a fact. But I don't remember him being in another game besides Adventure. Because there's Dark Matter, there's Magalore, and Yin Yan, this game. Triple Deluxe was Queen Sectonia and that other dude, Dive, Taranza. And, I kind of have an idea with, Robobot. I haven't played it yet, so... The names aren't really familiar to me, but... Yeah. I don't know if there's another well, besides Nightmare in Dreamland, which is... I think that's the, remake of Adventure. I could be wrong, but either way, yeah, if I'm wrong, please tell me, because, oh crap, please tell me, because I honestly can't think of any. Like, not even the Dreamland series, I believe. Like, I think Dreamland 3 was Dark Matter. But I could be wrong. Actually, no, I need to get something to destroy the cake. Oh wait, can I do the use of ton? Yes, I can. Woo. Oh, I was about to say, like, is there not, isn't any, anything coming out? At least you don't lose beads from standing on that. Bit of a contrast from the rest of the game, getting crushed by things, but hey, I'm all for showing the game showing a little bit of mercy. I mean, we don't want to have Pancake Kirby. How would that even work as a power? I mean, I don't know. I mean, what were the ones in Triple Deluxe? There was, well, the new ones anyway. There was Circus, there was, what else? Well, I know there was more, obviously, but there was Circus, I'm kind of drawing a blank, actually. Oh no, there was Beetle. I think that was the name of it. I know for a fact there were, like, a few others. Is Archer a new one? Okay, I could be wrong, but I'm gonna say Archer. I honestly, preferred the, new abilities Return to Dreamland Gate brought to the table over Triple Deluxe. Like, Beetle's alright. I like Archer. Circus, I'm not really the biggest fan of because it's very, like, just kind of. What's the word? Unorthodox. And it's not really helpful half the time. Like, it just takes years for it to finish attacks and. Eh, I can live without it. I think it was brought back in Robo, but for some reason, don't know why you'd want to bring something like that back. But hey, I mean, it's charming, it's cute, but style over substance. And we will be playing more normal Kirby games. Don't you worry about that. I will be playing stuff like Return to Dreamland. I don't know about Triple Deluxe because I don't really have a way to record 3DS. And that might be a bit... Yeah, that just in general would just be pretty difficult to do. And I'm not really fond of the idea of just forking over a good chunk of my income. Alright, so here's what you have to do here. You basically need to, well, not just get the bees, but also you need to kind of build a path for regular Kirby to get through. Alright, so I can just get rid of this so I can... No, wrong thing. Ugh. Alright, that works. And that works. Okay. Just carefully trim through this so I can get the beads. I don't need to, but hey. Alright, just... Whee! I don't think that's even faster. Alright, now let's try and get up there. First off, okay, cool. Oh, okay. Maybe I can do this? If I just, like... This is not... Right. Nah, okay. I need to, open up a path there. Alright. Okay, I'm pretty sure you can't just cheese the system and, like, avoid the transformation. Let me try it. Yeah, no, it just drops you straight in. I couldn't even move. Okay, so... I'm just gonna go around. So you can go up to here, and then this kind of messes up. So, if I... Wait, no, actually. No, wrong, bad move. Alright, so, do that. Yeah, that should do it. I can just go over here, right? Yep. Okay. This is probably the best use of the, digging, or the... Yeah, the shovel ability, or whatever you want to call it. Yep, there we go. Dessert. Now I just need the CD, and it will be all good. Alright. It's probably down there. If I'm correct, like, the treasures are just going to be in the same kind of, whatchamacallit, thing you pull out, because all the others seem to just be beads, at least from experience. I didn't mean to dash there. Yeah, until I'm proven wrong, I'm just going to assume they're all in, the treasures are just in those, exclusively. Like, I know there's treasures that are just out in the open, but in terms of what you can find in those types of things, I mean. Alright, nope. Yeah, I had a feeling that this whole thing was just a pit, so... Alright, that's good enough. Actually, can I just jump on this? Nope. It's not solid. And... Maybe? Nope. Okay, so maybe one more level then, boss? Yay! I haven't had a lollipop in a while, actually. Yep, I'll do the beads. I'll do that stuff later. Just hold your horses.